information that we need, something we need to be talking about that maybe we're not?
I think about this topic about how far right can benefit from EU funds and sometimes abuse about it. There were some investigations which had been already made about it, and it was very interesting, but I felt like it was not going enough into the topic, and I wanted to describe what they were actually doing with the money. I think the investigation which were made before just told that maybe they shouldn't have get the money because they just they matched with the conditions, but in a weird way they were abusing these conditions, and I wanted to show that abusing the EU funds, they were misusing it, and that was my first thought. Second thought was, or second reason why I wanted to work on this topic is I'm a local journalist, and I found out that one of this party was actually located in a very small village just next to my village. So I found this information to be very interesting to get to people around me in Alsace, around Strasbourg, to get to know this party, and so they have a better and more concrete view on how EU funds can be abused by far-right parties. And the third reason was last May 2018, we were 1 year before the European elections, and there was always this speech about how EU is spending the taxpayers' money and misusing it, and this is a speech from the far right, so I was very willing to show that this speech is a hypocrisy, I guess.
Annika, your project again obviously is sort of networks and looking at these think tanks, as I mentioned. How did you go about doing this? I mean, I obviously read the investigations and saw